Hey guys, it's Celestia, and today I'm going to be talking about why I switched my online store to Etsy, as well as the pros and cons that I've found with it so far. While I've been selling my work online for the better part of a decade, I've only been using Etsy since November of 2020, so keep in mind while listening to this that I'm by no means an expert on it, nor am I particularly familiar or well-versed in how it used to be and how it's changed over the years. But anyway, let's go over a brief history of my previous online shops to explain a little bit more about how I got here. When I was around 16, I started focusing on art as a long-term professional goal. This is around when I started selling at conventions and taking commissions and building myself a portfolio. Naturally, this is also when I started trying to find other ways to monetize my art, which meant taking my first steps towards selling my art online. When I first started out, I had three stores, on which I exclusively sold art prints, and I used Redbubble, Society6, and Inprint. All of these stores existed because the research I'd done said they were good options, and as I wanted to reach as many people as possible, I sold my stuff on all of them. Grown adult me knows that having three separate stores selling the same stuff is absolutely not feasible long term, it's infuriating to keep up with, and it's detrimental to brand recognition, but 16-year-old me just really wanted people to like my stuff and give me cash no matter the cost. And that pretty much has not changed at all, because I still rely on cash and validation for serotonin, but who doesn't? Anyway, I used these platforms for a couple years, and because I was still finishing high school and living with family and not needing to pay rent, I wasn't relying on them for income or promoting them regularly. Which is good, because I think I made like 5 sales collectively on Redbubble and Society6, which was only when I also started making apparel designs and selling them there, and I have literally never made a single sale on Inprint to this day. Anyway, eventually I did move out with my partner and we did need income, and I wanted to pursue art professionally. So I took a real look at these platforms as ways for me to make money, and I was not impressed. When it came down to it, I gained almost no traffic from their marketplaces, and the profit margins left me making so little per sale that it was almost not a profit at all. Beyond that, you can't have your own actual store that's customizable or individualized. You're just a page on their websites, and you can only sell items from their catalogs, which means that you can't branch out into selling a combination of things that are manufactured by a third party and things that you make yourself. All of these things combined made me decide to close my Society6 and Redbubble stores, although I think I technically still have an Inprint store somewhere. I kind of forgot about that. It just became irrelevant to me. Anyway, I took some time away from selling online to decide what I wanted to do store-wise, and did some real research that wasn't impulsive teenage Google searches and then instant impulsive store setups. Around this time, I started work on my first big independent project, which was the Happiness is a Choice fanzine. I had just finished my contribution for another fanzine, which was the first time that I ever had the opportunity to work on one. And because I was unbelievably obsessed with the video game We Happy Few, at the past tense there is kind of redundant because I'll always be obsessed with that game, but moving on, I decided to take the leap and make a zine of my own dedicated to that game. To be clear, I don't actually think happiness is a choice, by the way. It's a phrase from the game that ties into the whole plot, but that's irrelevant to my point here. So just check out the game if you're interested, because it's fantastic. Anyway, when the zine was produced and ready to be sold, I did a bunch more research on online stores again, because I needed to find one to sell it on. And I decided on Big Cartel. Big Cartel, if you're not familiar with it, is an online store platform that's pretty simple, because it's not a marketplace or fulfillment company like Redbubble or Society6, but just a platform that'll host the online store you make with it. You drive your own traffic and make your own products. So I used Big Cartel for the month or two that the zine was for sale, and I familiarized myself with it a lot. And I came to the conclusion that it was a beautiful, beautiful thing that I wanted to use for myself too. Which brings me to 2019 and 2020, when I opened my own Big Cartel store. At this point, art prints were no longer my main focus, as I was instead selling mainly apparel, which I designed myself and then had fulfilled through Printful, which is a dropshipping company that essentially prints my designs on shirts as soon as they're ordered from my store, and then ships them directly. And a brief shout out to Printful here, because that company is the definition of duality. In fairness, the quality of their printing and apparel is fantastic. Their platform is super easy to use, and they ship quickly and reliably. But they also gouge Canadian sellers at every turn, have a million hidden fees specifically for sellers outside of the US, worsen those fees with literally every update, and show no sign of stopping, ever. Like, if I sell the exact same sweater with the exact same design to a Canadian customer, I make 13% of the profit that I would make had I sold it to an American customer. And they've addressed this by saying essentially, "Yup, sucks. Don't be a baby about it, because it won't be changing anytime soon." I'm going to be trying Printify in the near future as an alternative, so if you guys are interested in a video comparing the two, let me know. But gripes with Printful aside, Big Cartel was hugely successful for me. I stuck with them for about a year, and honestly, if it weren't for the fact that I struggled to drive my own traffic to my store because I'm still a very small creator with a very small audience, I would absolutely have stuck with them indefinitely and not switched to Etsy at all. I used the Platinum plan, which was $9.99 a month, and it gave me everything I needed and more, with no fees added beyond that. Their analytics were great. That plan included a custom domain and 50 listings, which at the time was enough for me. Their site designs were pretty versatile and probably would have been a lot more so if I were better at editing code. It was user-friendly and very straightforward and streamlined. Their customer service was excellent. I could honestly gush about Big Cartel for hours on end without stopping, because that platform is genuinely just the best. I love it. I miss it. And if you can drive your own audience successfully and consistently, I would hands down recommend them. But again, I couldn't, and still can't. And after hearing a million and one good things about Etsy, I decided it was worth it to give it a try. So what I did was give Etsy a super secret trial run for a month. Because the only reason I was considering switching to it in the first place was to have its marketplace bring me traffic, I wanted to see for myself whether or not that traffic was actually significant enough to warrant the switch. So while keeping my Big Cartel store up and continuing to promote it, I also started an Etsy shop that I didn't post anywhere, so that I could see exactly how much of a difference Etsy's marketplace would make without me bringing any of my own traffic, or even posting a link to it anywhere. I honestly wasn't expecting much, because as a millennial, cynicism is embedded into the deepest fibers of my being. But to my obnoxiously loud and squealing surprise, I actually made my first sale within hours of opening the store. And that kind of engagement continued throughout the trial month pretty consistently. So while I loved and still love Big Cartel, and actually do prefer it as a platform, Etsy pretty much single-handedly saved my business with its marketplace, and that was not something I could pass up. So after that month was up, I switched over completely and announced it publicly. Since then, the improvement in sales and engagement has been consistent and reliable, and I've never doubted once that switching over was the right thing to do for me. Because honestly, in my experience so far, the marketplace on Etsy is just incomparably invaluable for small artists like me without big followings that rely on external traffic. That said, it might not be right for everyone, and I've certainly experienced my share of the negatives that Etsy has to offer in addition to the positives. So if you're considering switching and want more information, this next section here is for you. So, now, we're gonna go over the pros and cons of switching your store to Etsy, at least from my experience and perspective. And just to be contrary, since most videos I've seen with pros and cons start with the pros, we'll start with the cons, of which there are actually quite a few. Some of them are nitpicky, mind you, but I'm a nitpicky person who's particular about pretty much everything, so you guys should probably be expecting that by now. Con number one is that just like Redbubble and Society6, you don't really have your own store. You have a page on the larger store that is Etsy. It's your shop, of course, and you can make your own policies so long as they abide by Etsy's own. But you can't have a custom domain, you can't customize your shop beyond adding a banner and information, and every store fundamentally looks exactly the same. The store layout itself is nice enough, but there's no way to stand out from other stores in terms of website design, which is both irritating and detrimental to brand recognition and loyalty. This is just one of many reasons that switching to Etsy means you'll have to struggle with customers thinking and saying, "Yeah, this shirt's really cool, I got it on Etsy," rather than, "Yeah, the shirt's really cool, I got it from this artist." There's really no way around this if your main store is on Etsy, and while there are solutions that help lessen the impact of this problem, it will always be a factor. Con number two is that it's an incredibly oversaturated market. Everyone and their dog sells their stuff on Etsy, and no matter how great and original your product is, there are going to be hundreds of people on Etsy selling that exact same type of stuff that will probably show up before you in a product search for that stuff. You're competing with an unbelievably huge market of creators, and unless what you're selling is as specific as monogrammed underwear for golden retrievers named Augustine, whatever you're selling will inevitably be overshadowed by hundreds of thousands of other products with the same tags in the same category. Again, there are solutions that help you work around this, like Etsy ads and SEO optimization, but there's still a huge downside to Etsy that shouldn't be overlooked with this. Con number three is what I imagine everyone was waiting for, and that's the fees. If you don't use Etsy, you might be thinking, but it's free to use, isn't it? And the answer to that is that while it's free to sit in a Starbucks and do nothing there, so much as breathing in the direction of a coffee is going to cost you $5. Yes, it's free to set up a store on Etsy, but they charge you 20 cents every time you list an item. And you might be thinking that's not so bad, but consider that if you're selling 500 buttons, it will charge you that 20 cents every single time you sell one button, not just the one time you make the listing. Because every time someone buys an item from you, even if you have a huge inventory of that item, Etsy renews that listing and charges you another 20 cents to sell another one. and those are just the item fees. There are also transaction fees and credit card fees and PayPal fees and so many hidden fees that they don't even explain to you that looking at a monthly statement from Etsy is liable to give anyone a headache. I would much prefer Big Cartel's $9.99 a month plan to Etsy's so-called free system, but alas, Etsy doesn't offer that alternative and probably never will, because the way they're doing it right now is more profitable for them. These fees can be very detrimental, in particular to stores that sell a lot of small items, because in those cases your profit margins are very low and you're relying on many sales rather than big sales. For example, I used to sell buttons individually for $1.50 each, leaving my profit margin per button at about 30 cents after shipping, which is fine given that the goal is many purchases rather than large ones. But with Etsy's 20 cent fee for every sale, in addition to the transaction fee, I would actually be selling at a loss. As such, I've completely stopped selling individual buttons and now only sell them as sets of 5 or more, because Etsy pretty much took away all alternative options for that. Con number 4 is that Etsy's system is one that heavily favors the customer. What this means is that for one, if there's ever a dispute between a buyer and a seller, Etsy will almost always side with the buyer. For example, say you sell faux fur hats that shed their hair and get ruined if you put them in the wash, and you put warnings all over the listing to wash them by hand or not at all and explain the risks. If you get a customer that washes their hat anyway, ruins it, and demands to return this ruined hat for a refund, you can tell them no, but they can go above you and escalate it by opening a case with Etsy. And if they do that, there's a 90% chance that Etsy will side with them and tell you to refund their item and accept the return, even if it's their fault, and you'll be forced to take a loss that you aren't to blame for, because again, this isn't your store. It's your page on Etsy's store, and they make the rules, no matter how biased and straight up awful those rules may be. Another way their system favors the buyer is the review system. Etsy shops that have only 5-star reviews or a 5-star review average are promoted way more consistently and aggressively by Etsy's algorithm, which means that the benefit to maintaining that average cannot be overstated. And most buyers know that, which means that even if Etsy itself doesn't tell you to do whatever it takes to please your customer, even if it means absorbing unnecessary costs and taking losses, a smart seller knows that they pretty much have to in most cases to ensure that they get a 5-star rating, because one bad rating can have severe consequences. And similarly to how Etsy would force you to refund the faux fur hat customer, they would also side with that same customer if they left you a 1-star review after they ruined the item themselves, because that technically doesn't violate any of Etsy's policies. Etsy does not and will not have your back in any customer disputes, and they'll throw you under the bus without hesitation if it means another satisfied Karen who spoke to the manager and got what she wanted. Sellers on Etsy are inherently and justifiably terrified of bad reviews, and that broken system is definitely a con to consider. Con number 5 is very specific to a certain type of seller, and it's that copyright claims are very easily submitted and fulfilled on Etsy. I'm not here to get into the morality of selling fan art, I will not be giving my stance on it. All I'll say is that if you sell products that even vaguely resemble copyrighted materials, there is way more of a risk that the copyright owner or a licensed third party will take down your listing for that product on Etsy due to the ease with which they can submit those copyright claims there. There's a great deal of merchandise that I had to retire because I was copyright claimed on Etsy, whereas I sold it without any problems on Big Cartel. There's a risk with selling fan art on any platform, of course, Big Cartel included, but the risk on Etsy is so much higher than anywhere else, and you're only allowed 3 copyright claims on your account before your store is shut down altogether, so the stakes are quite a bit higher too. These last 2 cons are more nitpicky than anything, which is to say that they suck, but they probably won't impact your business or finances. So with that in mind, con number 6 is that contrary to what I've seen a lot of people say, making listings and setting up your store is not easy. Etsy is glitchy and not particularly user-friendly in many ways, especially if you're like me and have to deal with setting up manufacturer integration with Printful for the majority of your listings. Printful integration, as well as integration with most fulfillment companies, is a glitchy and infuriating aspect of setting up your store, especially when compared to how easy it is on Big Cartel. But if you make all of your items yourself and you don't use a manufacturer, this con probably won't apply to you. Finally, con number 7, the last one, is that there's no PayPal integration for sellers. To be clear, customers can use PayPal to buy from you if you choose to allow that. What I mean here is that you get paid directly to your bank account and you pay Etsy directly from your bank account. There's no option to pay them or receive your payments to or from a PayPal account. As someone who only has a personal bank account and doesn't have one for business, this is infuriating beyond belief. With Big Cartel, I could receive all of my payments directly to my business PayPal and leave it there, keeping my work money and my personal money completely separate. But Etsy has rendered this impossible for me. Alright, now let's move on to the pros, because ultimately, none of these cons were enough to deter me from using Etsy, and these pros are why. Number one, which I've already gone into, is the marketplace. The amount of traffic that Etsy can bring to your store through its marketplace is incredibly significant, because they have such an enormous and established audience already, that if even a tiny fraction of that audience ends up at your store, that's still a very notable number of people. Whether you're like me and struggled to drive your own traffic or not, you'll probably still benefit from Etsy's marketplace traffic. And Etsy itself actually shows you in your analytics how much of your traffic was generated directly by you and how much of it came from them, which is very helpful information. Their analytics are also very comprehensive and helpful altogether, actually, which is another pro in and of itself. Pro number two is that it's an easy and low-risk platform to try out if you're not sure about it yet. Setting up a store with a few listings as a trial run to see how it works for you will cost you almost nothing. So even if your store tanks and you decide not to go with Etsy, you won't have lost much. There's almost no downside to at least giving it a shot, at which point you can see if it works for you and choose whether or not to invest more time, money, and loyalty into it. Number three is that as a platform, Etsy itself is a household name. People know Etsy. People trust Etsy. And even people who don't normally buy from small businesses know to go to Etsy if they want to. It's a very, very well-known and trusted platform that people feel comfortable and safe buying from, which means that all of those people will, by extension, feel comfortable and safe buying from you if your store is on it. A customer that might otherwise be suspicious or unsure about buying from an independent creator they don't know well would be a lot more likely to buy from that same creator if they were selling on a platform that they were familiar with. Number four is very simple and straightforward, but much appreciated nonetheless, and it's that Etsy handles taxes for you. You don't need to worry about them, and this includes VAT, which, if you're unfamiliar, is value-added tax. And that's a fee that's added to orders that you receive from the majority of Europe and some other countries as well. It's a nightmare, and I can't actually explain more about it because thanks to Etsy, I don't really need to know more about it. They handle it for you and you can live in blissful ignorance of the nuances of international taxes, aside from how they impact your profits. Fifth pro is the versatility of Etsy. So while Redbubble and Society6 only allow you to sell items that they fulfill and manufacture for you, Etsy gives you the same marketplace feature that they have, but better, while also allowing you to sell anything that you want. Personally, I sell apparel, prints, and stickers that Printful fulfills and sends out for me, while also selling buttons and jewelry that I make and ship by hand. You can also sell digital items, although I know a lot less about that and how it works. This pro is one that the majority of online store platforms share, but it is a huge advantage over the majority of marketplace sites like those I've listed already, because you get the best of both worlds, which is a phrase that Hannah Montana has truly tainted and ruined even into adulthood, because I still can't say it without hearing that song and it haunts me when I sleep at night. Next, pro number six is that it's a very interactive platform for both buyers and sellers. Buyers can favorite your shop and get updates when you add new listings, and they can favorite items directly from your store to buy at a later date. Etsy even allows targeted marketing campaigns specifically for people who favorite your items, which means that if you choose to launch one of these campaigns, Etsy will automatically send people who favorite your items a discount that you decide on to entice them into buying those items, which is helpful beyond belief and incredibly easy to do. It's also interactive via its messaging system, which is a valuable asset for many reasons. Potential buyers have the ability to message you directly about any items they're interested in. Past buyers can contact you about any problems they may have had with their purchases. You can contact buyers about any problems with their orders. It's just so handy. I've made more sales than I can count because buyers were able to use this messaging feature to request custom orders or unavailable sizes or colors, and that's something that not even Big Cartel could offer. Also worthy of mentioning are a few more general pluses, like easy inventory management, the user-friendly system, at least where third-party manufacturer setup is not concerned, their frequent marketing update emails on what's currently popular and selling well, and Etsy Ads, which is a paid service that they offer where you can pay any amount between $1 and $25 a day to have your listings pushed higher up in the list of search results when people search for certain items. It's affordable and beneficial, although you do get what you pay for if you choose a lower amount to invest. In conclusion, I'm very happy that I made the switch to Etsy, and I'm confident that I'll be sticking with it for the foreseeable future, even with the cons that I mentioned in mind. I think that particularly for small creators without big audiences to drive their store traffic, Etsy is kind of like a crutch, as it can provide you with its own audience and supplement what you're missing. But if you do have an audience of your own, or eventually grow one using Etsy, I think at that point the cons begin to outweigh the pros as far as Etsy is concerned. The biggest draw, in my opinion, is the marketplace, and if you don't need that, there are way better alternatives out there to use for your store. Personally, I know that once I develop an audience big enough to drive my own traffic, I'll eventually either be switching back to Big Cartel or trying out Shopify. But in the meantime, I'm very happy with Etsy and encourage people in the same boat as I am to give it a try. Anyway, before I conclude what has once again become a way longer video than anticipated, I want to thank Fiona Paolo for this beautiful Duchess Celestia fan art. I can't begin to express how grateful and overwhelmingly happy I am to have received 3 pieces of fan art of my mascot. I mean, the fact that you guys have wanted to draw my girl Celestia and made such gorgeous art of her is unbelievable to me. And not only is Fiona's art amazing, by the way, her channel is too. If you like my content, you'll definitely like hers because she's also an art commentary channel with the added benefit of being way better with words than I am. Seriously, her videos are fantastic and she's an awesome person, so please go check her stuff out. I'll link her channel in the card above as well as the description of the video. Alright, thank you guys for watching and I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe. And don't forget to vote on this week's Twitter poll linked in the description if you want to say in what I talk about next. I do have a surprise video and challenge coming up soon as well, which will be posted in addition to that week's video. So keep an eye out for that too. Stay safe and I'll see you in my next video.